Hey guys, Triple C. Welcome to another video review on hardwares. Today I'm gonna show you RAmos W9 Tablet PC.
The rest in the box is a user manual and warranty sheet. So that's the package. It also comes with the power adapter, of course. The package is pretty sleek and simple, which is nice. Okay, so let's look at the connectivity. Here we have a headphone jack, HDMI cord, and a port for a power adapter, and the USB to PC port. And on this side, we have a power switch, plate, and menu. And here we got, that's volume, plus and minus. And nothing else for the rest of the machine. Booting up comes slow. It's okay, it's not so bad. Most of the time you leave it standby anyway. Okay, so this is the RAmos W9 tablet. Actually, what do they call it? Is it a computer? Or what is it supposed to be? So anyway, it's running on Android, Google's Android 2.1, yeah, which is kind of cool. And what else is in there? I can't really say much about the hardwares because I can't really detect it. And this machine I got, it's actually a simple. So I can't really tell you how much gigahertz or how fast the processor it is, but I can tell you it does have 256 megabytes of RAM, and from the system info it should have like 8 gigabytes of internal storage, and it, of course it supports a microSD card right there. It's pretty cool. Okay, so let's look at some of the things you can do. First of all, web browsing, since it's right there. Alright, so let's go to random websites. The device is connected to my wireless router, so the speed is pretty good. So just as you expected, how wide browsing is like on a device like this. And of course, you can tilt it just like the phone. View it differently. The Facebook application. It's basically, we all know it, Facebook for those kind of device. Nothing fancy. Typical, it's just like any other cell phone really. So, that's it for that. Let's see, what's next? Maps, I think we're bored of maps, video player, audio player. So there's a bunch of applications that download, let's check them out. High calculation, it doesn't do too good compared to some of the faster machines. I really want to know how fast the processor is, but then I don't know which application I can use. Most of the application I use only detects its current speed, and its current speed isn't so high. Anyway, let's do something cool. Let's play a game. I wanna start a new game. I should find this game really fun. Helicopter. I'm not too sure what to run. Oh, here's the 2D benchmark. Check it out. This device is actually really bad for 3D. I don't know if I don't know enough about this machine yet, or if there's something I can unlock. I'm still trying to figure out how to root this machine so I can run different applications. But average 2D, 58 frames per second. Or at least you can handle 2D just fine. Alright. So let's check out YouTube, shall we? There's something that they brag about on their website and the promotional video is that they can play YouTube. Good. I don't see what the big deal is, but yeah. Let's close some of the application that I opened earlier. I don't need you anymore. Kill. Okay, actually, let's see. I don't need to do any settings. I don't need Facebook. Need to play that game anymore. I don't really want to do anything anymore. I killed everything. Okay. XDA, I don't need it to be on. Okay, now. Let's go back to YouTube thingy. And then let's search for my own video. What I searched before. And then we're gonna watch Black Ops.
Ready? Consider your level of the canopy. Prepare. Call targets as I see them. Understand? Wind forward is crimson.
Yeah, so the capabilities of videos realize. So anyway, this video is really just give you a tour on this machine, like a quick tour. There's still a lot I need to learn about it. There's still a lot of cool application I've never seen before. So we're gonna do it as it goes. I find those kind of application and I'll do videos about them. I find something that's cool, I do videos about them. Otherwise we don't pretty much know what it can do. And here's the messenger thing. MSN on Android. Which is nice. And when you exit, you see some the top so you can switch it over anytime. Okay, I'm not gonna drag the video much longer. So that's that for now, just to give you a glimpse on what it's like. Oh, there's some of the functions on the Android 2.1. You can set up widgets, it's like those desktop little gadgets, which I don't want to do anything with them. There's all kinds of things going on, there's all kinds of benchmark. They are overclocking tools, but I still need to learn about them. So thanks for watching, and I shall be back with more videos related to this machine in a specific form.